Hello friends, welcome to Derivatives 101 series. In this series, in approximately 10 to 12 videos, I'll introduce you to the concept of derivatives completely. For example, what are derivatives? What are different types of derivatives? Why derivatives exist? What is the history of derivatives? What are the basic risk and compliance issues in derivatives that you should be aware about? And how you can make career with the expertise in derivatives? In the 201 series, I'll be covering forwards and futures. In 301 series, I'll be covering options and so on. So let's start with understanding derivatives. First and foremost, let's understand what are assets. Assets are anything that give us long-term economic benefit. For example, if I take a cab or a rickshaw to go from my house to somewhere else, I am not creating an asset, it's an expense. But if I buy a car, that car I can use for a number of years and it will give me long-term economic benefit, so I am creating an asset. There are broadly two types of assets, real assets and financial assets. Examples of real asset include building, land, plant and machinery, furniture, vehicles, so on and so forth. Real assets are backed by law. For example, if I purchase a land or I purchase a building, I register it under Transfer of Properties Act. Likewise, if I purchase a furniture, a mobile phone or a computer, it gets transferred in my name through Sale of Goods Act. Likewise, we have financial assets. For example, equity, fixed income, derivatives and so on and so forth. These assets are also backed by law. For example, Securities Contract Regulation Act, which broadly governs equities, and Negotiable Instrument Act, which covers assets like promissory note, bill of exchange, check, and so on. Financial assets themselves can be categorized using some of the criteria. For example, we have ownership instruments like equity and preference shares. We have debt instruments like bonds, debentures, FDs. We have investment vehicles like mutual funds, alternative investment funds like hedge funds, and so on, and derivatives, which is the focus of this series. Ownership instrument examples include equity, which is called ordinary equity at times, differential voting rights shares or DVRs, and preference shares. Debt instruments are of various types. We have government securities like treasury bills, G-Secs or long-term government securities or bonds. We have corporate bonds. We have commercial paper. We have certificate of deposits. We have something like a fixed deposit and so on and so forth. Investment vehicles, there are broadly 3-4 examples. We have mutual funds. And there are various categories like money market mutual fund, equity mutual fund, etc. Then we have alternative investment funds like private equity, venture capital, and hedge funds. Now, when it comes to derivatives, these are basically instruments used for hedging risks. These are risk management instruments. And fundamentally, they seek to protect those who take position in derivatives from fluctuations in the price of underlying assets. So derivatives are instruments created on top of some other assets or cash flows, and therefore they derive their value from those underlying assets. If the value of the underlying assets changes, the pricing of the derivatives change. So through derivatives, you can take exposure to some of the assets, and you can also leverage. By paying X amount, you can take exposure of, let's say, 10X. Examples of underlying assets include commodities, with which derivative products started a very long time back. Commodities could be cotton, wool, groundnut, sugarcane, wheat, rice, metals like precious metals like gold, platinum, silver, can include energy, for example, oil, crude oil, or even electricity. Nowadays, we have derivatives on, let's say, Bitcoin, which is a cryptocurrency. So a wide variety of underlying assets are available on which derivatives are being built. Though fundamental purpose of derivatives is hedging of risk or risk management, they are also used widely for speculation. For example, a huge part of turnover of futures and options segment on, let's say, National Stock Exchange is speculation, trading and arbitrage, because these assets can be very easily bought and sold and the liquidity is pretty high. There are broadly 4 types of derivative products. Number 1, forwards. Number 2, futures. Number 3, options, and number 4, swaps. Derivatives can be traded on the exchange, which are called exchange-traded derivatives like futures and options, or they may be traded off the exchange or over the counter between two counterparties. Examples of OTC are typically swaps and forwards, whereas futures and options are typically traded on the exchanges. In derivatives 101 series, I'll be covering history of derivatives, reasons for growth of derivatives markets, different types of products and markets, structure of the market and the players who participate in the market, risk and compliance related to derivatives, significance of derivative markets, and career opportunities available to you by understanding derivatives better. In the next series, as I mentioned, I'll be covering forwards and futures, options, and so on and so forth. I hope this video has been found useful. The expertise in derivatives can open up a lot of career opportunities for you. For example, in sales, trading, analyst positions, risk management, compliance, technology, and so on. If you found this video useful, please do like this video, share it with your friends who may find this useful, and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Cheers.